Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I have received two juror questions from you. The first juror question submitted late yesterday afternoon states that we are not unanimous. Votes have been steady since last Thursday. Jurors have indicated minds are made up. Some have indicated we either let you know today or they want off this jury. In my assessment, we are hung and additional time will not change this. Submitted by the foreperson. This morning I received an additional juror question indicating the status is unchanged as of this morning. Is there anything from the foreperson to add at this time? All right, at this time, the court is declaring a mistrial. Are we ready to proceed to sentencing?
Oh, Your Honor, Ms. Arias is requesting approximately 30 days. My understanding from our previous conversations is April 10th was available to the court. I just don't think we had a time indicated from the court.
And April 10 will not work for the state. The next of kin have requested that the sentencing be set either on a Monday or a Tuesday.
All right. We'll certainly accommodate that request. April 13th or April 14th? Mr. Martinez, do either of those work?
Either one will work for us. Let's go with April 13th.
Mr. Nurmi, April 13th?
Your Honor.
April 13th, 8:30 a.m. for sentencing.
What time, Your Honor?
8:30. It is ordered that a pre-sentence report be prepared. And I'm going to order the defendant held pursuant to Rule 7.2, which I believe she's already being held.
Your Honor, it's my understanding that Ms. Arias is either waiving her right to a pre-sentence interview and or requesting that counsel be present when said interview is taken. I'd like the minute entry to reflect that.
Well, which is it? Does she want a pre-sentence report or does she not?
My understanding is she's decided not to participate in said interview.
Ms. Arias, you have a right to have a pre-sentence report prepared. Your attorney is indicating you wish to waive that right. Is that correct?
Yes.
We will so reflect. All right, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the parties, myself and my staff, I wish to thank you for your extraordinary service on this case. The admonition is lifted. You are free.